When I say the word supervolcano, what do you immediately think of? Yellowstone? Mount Vesuvius? Just a terrifying image of a gigantic lava-spewing monstrosity? So, what exactly is it? By definition, a supervolcano is capable of creating a volcanic eruption with an ejective volume higher than 240 cubic miles, which is actually 1,000 times greater than the average volcanic eruption. Supervolcanoes also have a larger size compared to typical volcanoes. They are flat and have natural depressions that are seen on the ground, unlike composite volcanoes which have steep sides. Even the calderas are so huge that some of them can be seen from space. The formation of supervolcanoes occurs when magma from the core is stagnant in the Earth's mantle but unable to break through to the crust. As the pressure builds up, it forms a pool of hot, glowing magma until the crust can no longer contain it. These eruptions could destroy cities, cover enormous regions with volcanic ash, lead to major food shortages, and drastically change our climate, just to name a few. Sure, there are only a handful of these supervolcanoes in the world, and eruptions are typically hundreds of thousands of years apart. But what if I told you that one of the biggest supervolcanoes is actually overdue for an explosion? The Yellowstone supervolcano is located inside Yellowstone National Park in the western United States. Its caldera measures about 45 by 34 miles, covering a majority of the northwest corner of the state of Wyoming. The deadly heat contained inside this giant currently powers all the famous attractions inside the park, such as the geysers, hot springs, and mud pots that over 4 million visitors go to see every single year. According to the scientists from the University of Utah, the magma reserve underneath the Yellowstone supervolcano is actually much larger than previously estimated. We knew that the magma chamber inside Yellowstone is about 3 to 9 miles below the Earth's surface, but according to a new report, the magma chamber is 2.5 times greater in volume, which measures 90 kilometers in length and up to 70 kilometers in depth. This could fill the Grand Canyon as many as 14 times. This supervolcano is estimated to erupt every 600 to 700,000 years. The last eruption was 640,000 years ago. So technically, the volcano could erupt tomorrow or in 60,000 years. That's reassuring. That eruption created a giant crater 1,500 square miles in area. It was 2,500 times the size of the historic Mount St. Helens eruption in 1980. If an eruption was indeed imminent, the movement of the magma through the crust would first of all trigger hundreds or thousands of earthquakes in the days, weeks, and months leading up to the final event. If the Yellowstone caldera erupted, the magma would spread across a 30 to 40 mile radius, destroying everything in its path. And that's just the beginning. Based on a study in 2014, 3 feet of volcanic ash would cover the surrounding states of Wyoming, Montana, Idaho, and Colorado, which holds a population of more than 8.85 million people, leaving much of the Midwest under a deadly dark blanket that would kill plants and animals, crush roofs, and destroy electrical circuits. But immediate destruction aside, farms would be polluted, waterways would be clogged, and this would cause a major food shortage. The cold ash raining down could affect as far as 500 miles, even dusting New York City with a thin layer of ash. The ash would also block sunlight and cause a major drop in global temperatures that would last a few years. Seems like the end of humanity is near, doesn't it? Well, not exactly. That's just half of the story. The rest is much more hopeful. Based on a report by the US Geological Survey, there should be no eruption from Yellowstone anytime soon. With the help of NASA scientists and experienced engineers, a plan is being devised that would divert the volcano's heat to prevent a possible eruption. NASA's plan to delay the super eruption is to make a hole in the side of the volcano and pump water through it. This would slowly cool down the volcano as the water is heated and comes back out. If given enough time to complete the process, the NASA team could take enough heat from the volcano to prevent it from ever erupting again. They also propose to make use of the heated water by utilizing it as a source of geothermal energy that could possibly fuel the entire Yellowstone region. The idea of a geothermal generator could yield energy at about 10 cents per kilowatt hour, which is not as expensive as some other energy sources. This clever plan proposed by NASA removes the deadly threat for a large population while at the same time provides a long-term energy source for the region. But it may take hundreds and thousands of years to neutralize this volcano. Talk about long-term planning. This idea is still a work in progress that NASA is hoping to solidify and implement as soon as possible in order to lower the risks of having a supervolcano volcano eruption. So, don't worry. The supervolcano doesn't seem like it's going to erupt anytime soon, contrary to many recent media reports. But if you're still wary, experts are closely watching the Yellowstone supervolcano and providing the public with monthly updates. If anything strange starts happening, you can directly view it on the USGS website. Thanks for watching! If you enjoyed this video, please let us know by giving it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, remember to subscribe to our channel and click that little notification bell below. There's new content every single week, so make sure you don't miss it. See you next time!